Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. My name is Anella and today's video is about historical fiction. Now, historical fiction is a beautiful genre that lets the reader get immersed in a historical setting in a much better way than any non-fiction book ever could. Unfortunately, this is also a genre that's a bit tricky to get right, so I've made a list of some things to avoid when writing in historical setting. Number one, not researching properly. This one might be kind of obvious, but there's light research and there's proper research. I would say only doing your research online would count as light research. Once you've chosen the time period and setting for your novel, you need to find relevant books on that subject. The reason why this is so important is because if you're going to write from the perspective of someone actually living there, you need to be aware of all the complexities of that particular society. While you could always Google yourself to these books, I would recommend the site 5books.com that specializes in having experts give recommendations on a given subject. So they give 5 book recommendations on a particular subject like Renaissance Italy, Victorian Britain, or World War II. So that's just a recommendation. Let's move on to number 2, and that's ignoring the gross stuff. You don't have to go back very far to find that the past was a pretty gross place, especially with the lack of indoor plumbing and things like dental hygiene, and sometimes, depending on the time period, lack of normal hygiene as well. People would go to the toilet in chamber pots and then just open the window and throw the contents out on the street. This is worth keeping in mind if you want your reader to be fully immersed in the harsh realities of your time period. Alright, so number 3 is to write about famous people instead of creating your own characters. Unless it's a biography, but then you're no longer writing historical fiction, are you? This one is perhaps according to taste, but I personally find it difficult to read a novel about a famous person like a king or queen, because then I just feel like I could read a biography instead. You can get around this though, because I understand the appeal of wanting to write about famous people. Like one of my favorite historical novels, Girl with a Pearl Earring by Tracy Chevalier. Despite being about the creation of a very famous painting, she didn't use the painter Johannes Vermeer as her main protagonist. She created the fictional character of Griet and had the story told from her perspective instead. This is a great example of how to use famous events or people without jeopardizing accuracy too much. And then we get to number 4, which is to underestimate the potential of subgenres. While we all dream of writing the next Pride and Prejudice, I would strongly recommend taking a look outside the box, the box itself being traditional historical romance and drama. There are so many things to choose from here, from murder mysteries, a thriller, or some supernatural elements. Adding a subgenre can really take your story to the next level. A great example of this being the Outlander series by Diana Gabaldon. She could easily have written a historical drama about an 18th century English woman who finds herself in the Scottish Highlands. She made her protagonist come from the 1940s instead, adding a time-traveling element and immediately making her story more interesting. So yes, I recommend taking a look outside the box before deciding on your final genre. Our 5th and final topic on this list has caused some debate over the years, and that is beware of romanticizing the past. Historical fiction has been around for centuries, and it's become a bit of a tradition to make out history as being much nicer than it actually was. An example of this would be the historical novel Ivanhoe, written by Sir Walter Scott in the 19th century, but taking place in the 12th century. It's like the godfather of stereotypical medieval romance with chivalric knights and beautiful ladies. Ivanhoe is commonly known to portray an idealized image of the Middle Ages, and historical fiction as a genre is normally guilty of this in one way or another. To be clear, this isn't much of an issue, unless it goes so far as to deny or ignore important problems of past societies. Throughout history, you can see racism, misogyny, anti-Semitism, homophobia, animal cruelty, etc. being spread out over the whole world. When writing historical fiction, authors tend to tone down or even completely ignore these issues in order to make their work more fit for a modern audience. Look, I get it. It's nasty and we don't like to read about such things. But despite this, it's important that we don't forget about the oppression and inequality of the past just because we find it unpleasant today. That was the end of my list. A small disclaimer, this list and the opinions expressed are my own and should not be regarded as a rule book or anything like that. But the points I mentioned, especially 1, 3 and 5, are worth considering if you want to stay true to history and be as accurate as possible. So thank you so much for watching, leave a like if you enjoyed it, and I hope to see you back next week.